For the fastest, cheapest, most reliable coins on the market, check out my coin sponsor, MMOXP.com, and use discount code MONEYSHOT to get 5% off your order. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Sniffing the Mad Cheese as always. Got a new update video for you guys today, and this one's pretty big. This is a pretty massive update. I think the last major update was October 4th. This one here might match that in size. There's a lot of new stuff here. Mostly, the most important ones probably are more geared towards new X-Factor abilities, new Superstar abilities, and there's also a few important gameplay bugs that they fixed in this that I'm going to go over. A lot of small tweaks, but very important ones when it comes to gameplay fixes. And there's also stuff for franchise mode, mutt, all that stuff, which I'm going to get into later. But before I do, if you guys are going to continue to keep you guys up to date on these updates, on these title updates, on these changes as they come throughout the year, make sure to be a subscriber, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. It really helps out the video and the channel, and I appreciate the support. Now I'm going to go ahead and start off at the top with gameplay changes before I get to the superstars and the X-Factors. There's a lot of players that lost Superstar and X-Factors too, by the way, so stick around for that. But let's start off with gameplay changes. The number one thing that I hear people complaining about the most in my comment section, and it has been that way for months, is the kick meter popping up in front of the kicking bar, which, you know, I had an issue with, I think, before they patched it. I think they tried to patch it in September. I'm not really sure. I think that was a September update where they tried to patch it. Or, oh no, maybe it was October. But either way, it came back. Whatever the last patch was in September, it came back. And I had people right away telling me in my comment section, oh my god, the kick meter's back. I know that's annoying, and it says that they fixed it again, but at the end of the day, it could always come back. They said that this is an issue that is caused when somebody pauses, and it creates that issue somehow. It says it's a meter to move after a pause and sometimes cover up the kick meter. So they fixed that for now, although it has come back already, so who knows, it might come back again. But it says, due to an integration issue merging the two previous title updates, a specific UI package did not reload properly in the latest pre-patch, so they had to reintroduce it. So it says they fixed it again. Probably not too difficult of a patch to do, but that was 2 weeks ago that I think it came back. So it was the kick meter thing was there for 2 weeks. There's a lot of other really good small issues that they fixed as well. They say they fixed an issue with avoidance logic sometimes causing receivers to stop their route when running a slant route. I have noticed that, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's nice that they fixed that. Doesn't happen a lot, but a lot of these are kind of small. There's another one that says fixed an issue sometimes causing user control defenders to attempt an effort catch instead of an actual catch attempt. Now, if what they're referring to is when you get that out of reach animation, which looks like it wasn't out of reach, a lot of times you'll get like that perfect accuracy out of reach animation. That's total nonsense. I'm hoping that's what they're talking about, because a lot of times it's like a forced reaction where you just don't get the, where you don't even get an opportunity to make the catch, and it's like, what do you mean out of reach? He was right there. How do you have perfect accuracy and throw the ball out of reach? That makes no sense. So hopefully that's what they're talking about, but I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, either way, the lesser that happens, the better. It also says fixed an issue causing the poor visibility dynamic gameplay modifier to impact the QB on a home team, which I can't say I've noticed too much. Fixed an issue causing the kick return to sometimes warp slide when catching a kickoff. Can't say I really noticed that too much. Fixed an issue preventing safeties in man coverage from aligning properly to split out running backs in dime 2-3 formation. Very, like I said, a lot of these are very minor. Now, it also says that they tuned to increase interception catch chance. I know a lot of people complaining at the last patch that they kind of reduced the ability to get interceptions, which I can totally understand, which I haven't had that issue. And I say in all these videos, if you're having trouble getting interceptions or catches at all, make sure you're rapidly tapping the catch button, whether it's the wide triangle button for interceptions or if you're rack catching, whatever. Make sure you're tapping the button repeatedly and you will not have drop issues. If you watch my videos, if you've ever seen me drop passes, it never happens. It's because I've been doing that since like Madden 20. So just make sure you're tapping that button repeatedly and you won't have that problem. Now, there is some blocking issues which they fixed, which is nice, because this first one here right off the bat I've seen a million times. It says fix an issue preventing the right tackle from targeting the defensive end when next to a block and release tight end, which happens a lot. If you check and release your tight end, or you know, whatever, sometimes if you block your tight end, they'll just, it just like messes up the blocking. You'll just see dudes just run right past your tackles. So I have noticed that quite a bit, so I'm glad they fixed that. Hopefully that'll fix some blocking issues. Now, they added some new post-play stuff to the gameplay as well. It says they added new signature walks and stances and gestures and facial animations for Josh Allen, Justin Jefferson, Micah Parsons, and Sauce Gardner. They also fixed Christian McCaffrey chest pound celebration, so he places the ball in the correct hand, which is small. Kyle Murray had some issue where his feet were twisting up after the whistle sometimes, or twitching, you know, stuff like that. Small changes. Now, after that, there are a lot of small blocking changes, but nothing too crazy that I really want to spend a lot of time on. So I'm going to go ahead and get to what, like, I'm sure most people are waiting for, which is the new X Factors. Now, I'm going to start off with the downgraded X Factor players, and there's some pretty big names here. Dalvin Cook is not a surprise at all. He's not doing anything in New York. It looks like the Vikings were pretty smart to let him go at the time they did, because he just went to New York and fell off the face of the earth. So, not a surprise there. DeForest Buckner, can't say I really follow the Colts too much, but I know he's still a really good player. This next one, though, is a definite surprise, as Joe Burrow is on the list of downgraded X Factor players. Joe Burrow lost his X Factor? I know he's not having the best year, but still, I mean, you could downgrade a lot of, if you're going to downgrade Joe Burrow, does anybody really lost faith in Joe Burrow as a great player? I don't know about that one. Joey Bosa also lost it. He hasn't really done a lot in years. I know his player rating's been going down lately, so he must not have been having a good year. He also has some downgraded superstar players. Chandler Jones, is he even in the league anymore? I mean, that's not surprising at all. I don't even know if he plays anymore. I remember seeing some crazy video of him on like Twitter or something, but it was like it had nothing to do with football. Alvin Kamara downgraded from a superstar. Calais Campbell downgraded from a superstar. T. Higgins and Fletcher Cox all downgraded from superstars. And I can't say I necessarily disagree with any of them, with the exception of Joe Burrow. Let me know in the comment section what you guys think about that. But let's go and let's start off at the very top with players that got new X Factors and new abilities. As far as, let's just go right with the X Factors that were added. Sauce Gardner, can't believe he didn't have one in the first place. He got shut down, which, makes sense. He definitely should have that. Jesse Bates also got shut down, and Marshawn Lattimore got shut down. Another guy surprisingly never had it. We also got run stuffer added to DeMarcus Lawrence, which is something that I think is typically saved for defensive tackles, if I'm not correct. But either way, there's a lot more stuff added to guys like DeMarcus Lawrence. He also got no outsiders, instant rebate, and edge threat. While Marshawn Lattimore also got bench press, and Jesse Bates also got pick artist. So those are all the guys that got new X Factors along with their superstar abilities. But there's a lot of players that got superstar abilities. I'm expecting to see a lot of Lions on this list. If you're not gonna put any on the superstars list, because the Lions are one of the best teams in the league, which is crazy. But let's start off at the top. One guy that I'm a little bit surprised, but not really. He definitely got it quicker than a lot of people. A lot of people waited for a long time, but we have a lot of rookies on here. Number one, Puka Nacua, which has short out elite and mid in elite, which is, pretty good. I mean, he's a slot guy for the most part, as far as I know. CJ Stroud got lofting deadeye, which seems like a weird one. I mean, he's already one of the best quarterbacks in the league. You could have gave him a little bit more love than just lofting deadeye. I mean, I was thinking about actually using the Texans quite a bit in some gameplays coming up, because I love the story of the Texans. They're an amazing story in the NFL right now for what they're doing. I thought they had one of the most talentless rosters in the world, and they're working with a rookie quarterback and they're already looking like a playoff team. You also got Tony Pollard, who isn't really having a great year, but they added some stuff to him. He's got jukebox now and reach for it. I don't really understand reach for it. Jukebox makes sense, but reach for it, I'm not really sure about that. But still, he's not even, I don't know. Once again, Cowboys just get a lot of love for what reason, I don't necessarily know. Bijan Robinson for the Falcons, another guy who gets more press for not getting touches, for not getting playing time. Amazing player. And he definitely deserves jukebox, because he's one of the stickiest dudes in the league. And he also got Energizer. But it's weird to see a guy like that get these things. Another team I want to use in the future, and I probably will now, know that Bijan Robinson has jukebox. But the Falcons, it's just weird to see. He gets all, they talk about him like he doesn't get used enough, and then they're giving him abilities. Devontae Smith for the Eagles got runoff elite and mid-out elite. I like runoff elite. That's huge for deep passing. I know from being an Eagles fan that they run that fade. Every time they see cover one, they run the fade. So I can understand why runoff elite would make sense for Devontae Smith. Tua finally getting some stuff. Sideline deadeye and fearless. Definitely going to make him a much better quarterback. Brock Purdy gets gutsy scrambler and inside deadeye, another team which I plan on using pretty soon. So it's going to be nice to have some superstar abilities on the quarterback for the Niners. T.J. Hockenson, mid inside elite and short inside elite for a tight end, pretty good. Good addition. I don't know how to say this next guy. Olokun from the Jaguars, really good linebacker, but he's got flat zone KO and tackle supreme. Definitely a Pro Bowl caliber linebacker every year. Seahawks, Kenneth Walker gets armbar and matchup nightmare, which is nice. Seahawks got a lot of weapons. Another Eagle coming in. I think we're getting to the defensive side here. Jalen Carter gets unpredictable and reach elite, which is nice to see. We got another Eagle. I'm gonna skip down to the next Eagle tier too. You have DeAndre Swift, who has bounce beam and energizer, which I don't really think, I mean, energizer doesn't make sense because I think DeAndre Swift's recent issues is coming from his lack of, I think he's just getting tired. I think he's already wearing down. So to give him energizer to make a lot of sense. I skipped over Josh Allen, who is from the Jaguars, obviously the pass rusher, gets edge threat and strip specialist, which is gonna make his sacks even more valuable because strip specialist is huge when it comes to getting sacks. Brandon Ayuk gets mid and elite and deep and elite. Very good route running receiver. Those make sense. And then the last one is Aiden Hutchinson, who I've been talking about for a while, gets edge threat and BOGO. So, you know, lots of really good improvements there. Now, if you play franchise, obviously this will be in franchise as well. It doesn't say whether or not you're going to have to restart your league to get them. So let me know in the comment section if these things are updated in your league or not, or if you guys have to restart your league, which obviously is usually something people don't want to do. Yeah, there's a lot of updates here too. I mean, you have reworked franchise tag selection logic for AI-controlled teams. They're going to, you know, make a better attempt to franchise tag their player. The dev note says AI-controlled teams will look into using the franchise tag based on a variety of new factors. As far as Ultimate Team, I mean, we all know Season 3 started yesterday. There's a lot of small fixes. I guess currencies were disappearing at times, and then they would reappear later. Timers for events. A lot of just weird little AI bugs that or IU bugs that happen in Ultimate Team that's been there forever. But most of the changes I already went over. I mean, the major stuff was pretty much the X factors and the gameplay changes. So I'm going to end the video there. If you guys, like I said, if you want me to continue to do this series, it's very quick and easy for me. I can keep you guys up to date. Like I said, just make sure to be a subscriber, hit like button, let me know in the comment section. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Wish it out.
Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bits and more. Link in the description below.